Would you like to know if the CCIE or Cisco Certified Internet Expert is still worth it? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GovCloud Careers, and I've been a cloud architect, a network architect, an enterprise architect, and a business architect for more than 2.5 decades. And yes, I am actually a CCIE, and I have been a CCIE for almost 24 years. You can see my number is 7417. And should you take the CCIE? Well, it really is dependent upon your goals. For most people, I would say yes, the CCIE is worth it. But there are others who could spend their time much better getting additional types of training. And in this video, we will explain if the CCIE is for you, or if you should pursue another means to build your networking career. Now, to explain the value of the CCIE, I want you to look at things from the perspective of the hiring manager, because the goal of any certification is either to get hired, get promoted, or increase your salary. So in order to talk about that, we really need to discuss what hiring managers care about. And then I'm going to show you the power of the CCIE for network engineers, and where it's not valuable or super valuable for other people. So what do hiring managers care about? They care about your ability to do the job and do it well. They care about whether they can trust you or not. They care about your energy, your enthusiasm, and passion for the work. They care about your emotional intelligence. They care about your willingness to go above and beyond and whether you're going to be a good team player. Now, generally speaking, hiring managers don't care about your certifications, but the CCIE is an exception, and here's the reason why. Most of the people that can actually pass the CCIE exam are competent. They can typically do the job of a network engineer, and they can do it well. Not 100%, but most people that pass the CCIE can actually function as network engineers and have good networking knowledge. So the CCIE will get you an interview, and in many cases, it will give you the skill to win the interview and get hired. So that's wonderful. Half of the value of the CCIE, I will tell you right now, is not the certification. It's going to be the knowledge that you get in order to pass the certification. And this is much different than a book certification or a paper certification where you can memorize practice questions and then answers to an exam and then pass it and know relatively little. You got to be pretty solid to pass the CCIE. Now, why else is the CCIE so helpful? Well, employers want energy, enthusiasm, and passion for the work. And let's talk about that. It's pretty tough to pass the CCIE. It's going to take you 6 months to a year minimum to do it. It's going to typically cost $15,000 to $20,000, and it's going to be hard work. Now, because of that, that shows a lot of energy, enthusiasm, and passion for the work. It also shows your willingness to go above and beyond. Because who else is going to pursue a certification that would cost them $15,000 or $20,000 and take them an entire year? Most people will do a bunch of mini certifications, which are easy to do compared to a big challenge like this. So the CCIE, as a rule, is a major win for network engineers, sales engineers, consulting engineers, engineers in networking. The CCIE is fantastic. Now let's talk about the CCIE for a network architect. And we're going to talk about the two kinds of architects here. At the architect level, this is where the CCIE, and even to some degree the CCDE, which is a design certification, begins to fall apart. Now, there's two kinds of architect levels, so let's talk about them. There's what's called a technical architect, and that is really a hands-on architect. It's mostly an engineer that does network design but may actually touch the technology. The CCIE is great for the technical architect, because a lot of technical competency usually comes out of the CCIE. Now, if you're trying to get into higher paying architectural careers, such as a chief architect or a chief network architect or an enterprise architect or even the leadership side of technology, here's where the CCIE is not so great, because it's getting you back into that hands-on position when you should be really focused on strategy at that point. So, what are the skills to move into these bigger, more strategic roles? It's not your ability to configure a router. It's your ability to solve business problems, and these skills require business acumen and leadership and sales skills and executive presence, emotional intelligence, presentation skills, and sales skills. So for an architect, the CCIE is in limited value. And I got to tell you, from my career, I've been a CCIE for a while. I'm proud of doing it. I had an enterprise architect role when I was at Cisco, and my manager, who was a VP, asked me to remove the CCIE and my CISSP from my business cards. And honestly, I asked him why. And my manager said, "Mike, you're now an executive architect in an executive architect role." He said, "Do you want to be seen as an executive architect, or do you want to be seen as a hands-on techie?" So I removed the CCIE. I focused on my business acumen, my leadership skills, my sales skills, my executive presence, my presentation skills. And it honestly did incredible wonders for my career. I kept getting promoted because I was now in an executive architect role. So it's all dependent upon your goals. So the CCIE, I still think, is incredible. So is the CCIE still worth it? Well, it really depends on your career goals. If you're just starting out in networking, yes, I would go do the CCIE. It's going to get you great skills. And when you pass that certification, it'll get you interviews at great companies. It'll give you the competency to pass most of those interviews. And I view the CCIE as my intro to networking. And here's the reason why. As soon as I had that CCIE, it was like, "Mike, I got this scary project to put you on, and another scary project to put you on." And that's where I really got to learn networking. That's where I got to work on things that were at scale, where things were going to break. And I learned more in the next 25 years about networking than I ever could possibly describe. So for people new or people that have not reached their goals in network engineering, yes, I love the CCIE. It's great. If your focus is on being an architect, I recommend you spend more time, instead of pursuing the CCIE, focusing on business skills, get an MBA, or at least focus on your business skills. That'll help you more in your career. If you'd like to build your architecture career, maybe become an enterprise architect or an artificial intelligence architect or a cloud architect, we've got not only free webinars and programs to help you. So join us on one of the free webinars that we actually have. They're completely free. They'll be on Zoom. We'll go over these careers. We'll talk about what we do. And you can ask us any questions you want live so we can help you in your career. We also have free ebooks in the descriptions of these videos. Ebooks on how to earn more in your technology career, win the interview, how to become certain types of architects. They're all completely free and they're in the description of this video. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of more videos to help you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off. I look forward to seeing you in a free webinar or in the next YouTube video. Take care.